Hello, that was an expert. Today I'm going to show you what's similar and different between iOS 5 and iOS 10. Because they are pretty similar, because they went through the same amount of beta stages as iOS 5 did. iOS 5 went to beta 8, and iOS 10 went to beta 8 also. And they have the same amount of features, big feature, like the biggest changes in the world. Like, iOS 5 was the first one to get reminders, newsstand, music from videos app for iPhone. And it was also the first one to get Notification Center. And iOS 5 was the first one to get over-the-air updates, which iOS 10 has now. If it wasn't for iOS 5, we wouldn't have software updates. And iOS 5 brought iTunes Wi-Fi Sync, the one we use all the time now. To sync it over-the-air now. And it was the first one to bring round toggles to the device. So here's my opposite second gen iOS 4. And I'll show you what I mean. This one has round toggles. iOS 4 has square toggles. See that? Square and round. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring location services out to the main generals tab. Which in iOS 10, it's in the tab called privacy now. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring iCloud. The one we use today. And the first one to bring Twitter integration into settings, which we use today. Pretty good, huh? And iOS 5 was the first one to bring usage tab for iPod Touch. Here the device bring iOS 4. When I go to general, there's no usage tab for the iPod Touch. That came in iOS 5. But iOS 4 is not the first one to bring accessibility. iOS 5 was the first one to bring the setting white on black. That was the first one that came into iOS 5. So iOS 5 was the first one to bring accessibility. Like, some of the features, but not like white on black. Like this. And it was the first to bring speak selection, zoom, and voiceover. Voiceover was right there, but larger text, white on black, speak selection, speak audio, emote audio, and triple click home. Those were the ones that came in iOS 5. Like, when I go general to accessibility, we have much more now. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring the app Find My iPhone to the device. Find My iPhone, the app for Find My iPhone came in iOS 5. So iOS 5 was the first one to bring the Find My iPhone app to the device. Same for Find My Friends. Right to the device. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring, like, purchase section where you download purchase free. Like, where you go to purchase tab. But look right here, on iOS 5. Once it loads, see? iOS 5 was the first one to bring that purchase tab. So when I go to iOS 4, and go to the App Store. Sorry, it's going to take a while for it to load. It takes a minute to load every time. But see, iOS 5 was the first one to bring that download cloud button to the device. Where you can re-download stuff for free and TV shows for free. See? No purchase tab. Look at the difference here. Purchased and no purchase. See that? iOS 5 was the first one to bring the re-download purchase button to download stuff from the cloud. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring this edit button and add albums to the device. See that? Where you can edit and add albums, which iOS 10 has it now. See where you go back out, like go to albums, you can edit that button, which iOS 4 and 3, 2, 1 did not have that at all. And iOS 5 was the first one to bring a new look for settings icon, where it's a little more round. See, here's iOS 4. Let me get my camera to adjust. Then here's iOS 5. As you can see that, the gears are a tad more lowered a tiny bit. And the icon's a little darker, as you can see that. Okay, now the different things that iOS 5 can, that these devices cannot do that are similar. Oh, I forgot to mention one more thing. iOS 5 was also the first one to bring these new ringtones, the ones we know of now, compared to iOS 4, where we get set different text tones now, compared to iOS 4, where you can only get these options. You cannot change your new male tone. You couldn't change each of the tones, which you can do now, right here. Like, text tone, that's where all these alerts came from. You thought these were in iOS 6, but they're not. They came in iOS 5. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, now the different stuff. The things that iOS 10 brought that iOS 5 cannot do. Like, Control Center, like Color Control Center, iOS 5 cannot do that. That came in iOS 7. The redesigned, like, Notification Center, which is not like old-fashioned text anymore. Snag this kind of stuff right here. And iOS 10 removed Game Center, which iOS 5 still had. And iOS 10 removed has Apple Maps instead of Google Maps, like on iOS 5. iOS 10 does not have YouTube pre-installed like iOS 5 has. And iOS 10 has a news app instead of newsstand like iOS 5. And iOS 10 has Apple Music, which iOS 5 does not have. And iOS 10 has a more cleaner look of the app switcher, which iOS 5 does not have. Like, those unlimited apps you can have, they're now digging iOS 5 and now have unlimited apps in the app switcher now. And the redefined look of the Safari, where it has the search bar integrated with the URL address, which iOS 5 has been separate, like that. Like up here where it has separate search tab and separate URL tab, what iOS 10 are combined. You can see that. And the different keyboard clicks. Let me check some here. Okay. Now listen carefully on iOS 10. Let me make sure my ring's on. Yep. Listen carefully to the keyboard clicks. Oh. Yeah, my ring is off. Here you go. See how we have those. See how the custom keyboard clicks, but on iOS 5, it's the same for all of them. And iOS 5 had this little animation where you went into different apps. Like, watch this. When I go to Green Door to install Theme, watch what happens when I install the profile. So I'm going to do the same for this device. Now watch carefully. Okay, so I'm going to Green Door to do this example here. So I'm loading the same website on both of them. The same site I showed you how to get iOS 7 on the older devices video. Links will be in the description for those older videos. But first, here's iOS 5's redirect animation. You see? Oh yeah, see how the pages go flips like that? Now look at iOS 10. It doesn't do like a page flipping over the other one anymore. Like that. It doesn't have that. Instead, it's just a slide over. Just like that. And iOS 5 had a button to refresh a mail instead of pull to refresh. Like how you have pull to refresh iOS 10. iOS 5 a little click button. And tap and hold to get to your recent drafts. When you do it on iOS 5, it'll just create a new message. And how iOS 10 has a live clock icon, iOS 5 does not have that. And how iOS 5 has podcasts pre-installed, but iOS 5 can get it too, but it's not pre-installed. If I can find it, because I messed up my home screen of that earlier. See, podcasts are completely different icons. Same for iBooks is pre-installed. But in iOS 10, you get removed system apps, which cannot do in iOS 5. And that's not all. In the clock app, you don't have this white background in the clock app anymore. See that? iOS 5, they removed this little clock face. They left the digital, and you don't get this clock face anymore. Like on iOS 10, you don't get a clock face like you can on iOS 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And the iOS 10 has the bedtime tab, which iOS 5 does not have. And a redesigned stopwatch, how iOS 10 has the cool old analog version, which iOS 5 only has 2 on the top. Like, that's the lapping number. When this keeps going, this keeps lapping. So iOS 10 has 2 of the two faces for the stopwatch instead of 1. And in the alarm, we go to Atom. You no longer get this custom separate color face, they're all the same color. And these tabs in iOS 10 have been swapped like this in iOS 5. All this info here was up here, and the time scroll is down here. Now, it's swapped. And listen to iOS 5 scrolling sound. Listen to the scrolling sound. That's the old one. Here's the iOS 10. Sounds like a combination lock being scrolled pretty fast. And you have these redesigned toggles that are green instead of blue. And you even now have an option to turn on-off labels off yourself. Like, when you go into accessibility on iOS 5, you don't see any. But when you go into here, you have an option to turn the labels for the on-off label, like, says off and on. But this one, you can enable that manually. When I turn that off, you don't have them. And in iOS 10, you can turn on button shapes, which this one does not have. But invert colors, iOS 5 does have, but no grayscale. Grayscale came in iOS 8. And iOS 10 has a magnifier where you can zoom in on things, which iOS 5 does not have. Same for bold text and the keyboard stuff, and you can turn off vibration, which iOS 5 does not have. No TTY, because iOS 5 still had it, but on iOS 5, in the older device, didn't have the thing. So let me get mine from 2G. I'll show you that the TTY setting's been there the whole time. This one, let me show you the version of this one. But on this one, you expect this morning iOS 4, but nope, this is my 3.1.3, the first iPhone. This one has a SIM card installed, so I can show you this. But TTY has been there ever since iOS 1.0 has. Because before, it was actually in the phone settings, right here. See that? No phone settings. Now let me get my 4S here and show you this. So my iPhone 4S running iOS 9. I scroll down the phone settings. TTY there. Because they moved it. In iOS 10, they moved it to the main generals tab. But if you're wondering why I don't have any of these here, because this is a Verizon phone, not AT&T. Oops, forgot to turn the alarm off. And in iOS 5, if you have an alarm, when you turn the alarm switch off in iOS, see how, watch carefully in iOS 5 when you turn it off, nothing doesn't gray it out, but in iOS 10, it now grays the alarm out. That's another difference in iOS 5 compared to 10. Oh, and in iOS 10, I mean, you have a wrong Wi-Fi, like when you tap it, it just doesn't do anything, but iOS 10, when you tap it, it takes you right into your menu here, all this cool stuff. That came in, that was iOS 10 feature. But let me try it on iOS 9, see if that was there before. Sorry, if it was hard for me to do my 4S because I don't have a home button in there anymore, it fell out. Comment below if you want to make a video on why it fell out. So here, yep, iOS 9 can do it too. Plus, I actually have found one feature that's been there, like how the newer devices, like when you go into another page, you can do this gesture. But I actually discovered in the music app on iOS 5, when you swipe, same thing. Like when I hit now I'm playing, I swipe, it redirects me back to where I want it to be. But this feature also works on iOS 3. Like, let me get my iOS 7 device here. So, he moved my other device out of the way. So, here is iOS 7.1.2. Now hit now playing. You tap a song. Okay, so watch carefully. Know the gesture we swipe over and it works like this. It also works in iOS 3. So that's the difference. So that's the difference between iOS 10 and iOS 5. That's it for this video. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Peace out.